For RCR Wireless News, I'm Sean Kinney, and we're here at the Dell Technologies stand at Mobile World Congress. Andrew Lilac, I'm really excited to talk to you about the collaboration between Dell and NVIDIA. Before we get into it, maybe we could do some quick introductions. Lilac?
Sure. Lilac Ilan. I lead AI for operation for the telco at NVIDIA. So that means I go talk to every telco around the world and advocate about the power of AI and generative AI.
Andrew Vaz, I'm the Vice President of Product Management at the Telecom Systems business at Dell Technologies.
Excellent. So, Lilac, artificial intelligence obviously positioned to really drive broad transformation across industries. Grounded in telecom for us, though, what are the big challenges that you think AI is well-suited to solve?
Absolutely. So, if we take a step back on generative AI and say, what can it do for every enterprise for a minute, right? Leave telco aside. It could do three things. It could help you serve your customer better, it could help run your operations smoother, and it can make your core product better. Okay, so now let's take it to telco. What does it mean? Let's ground it in telco. And Dell did a beautiful job bringing an ecosystem of partners to help with those three challenges. So let's talk about how you can help service your customer better, from assisting an agent to digital avatars in a retail store. Those are things that's done every day, right? You guys brought some partners like Amdocs that's doing billing and care agents, so bringing agentic AI to the telco as a solution. Let's talk about how you can make your operation run better and smoother. So this is where you're bringing partners. Again, Dell has brought Kinetica that's helping run the operation of the network smoother. And then let's talk about how you make your core product run better. So there are specific differentiated services that you can build on top of your data plan. Like, can you now do a small business agent on top of a data plan all packaged together for a small business to the enterprise? So things like that, or if you look today in the show, there's a lot of solution for AI for the RAN. Right? How do you start bringing the core product of a telco? Totally transformative to get spectrum efficiencies and so forth. So I think those three areas combined together with a solution of partners is where we can solve challenges for the telcos.
Well, that's a great overview of the opportunity space. Andrew, maybe you can give us a little bit of background on the joint solution you've developed with NVIDIA and tell us how you see that coming into market.
Yeah, absolutely. So we see several things. So first of all, it's been a great partnership for us. The marriage of the companies and the technology has gone extremely well. So here's what we're seeing really in the telecom space. When we go talk to telecom operators and think about our solution set and how they use it for AI use cases, we literally are getting hundreds of different use cases. We tend to bucketize them into about three different categories at Dell, and when we look at them, we see a couple of different things. One is the network efficiency, performance improvements, et cetera, set of use cases. So this is, hey, how can I use my network and use AI to run it more efficiently? How do I, it could be anything from like, I want to control how much power efficiency I have in my RAN. It could be, I would like to do predictive analytics or anomaly detection.
Fraud
is a wonderful one, right? So this has been a great set of use cases, and we're seeing this across the board. Typically, the network operations team is very interested in how I do this. The second one is around customer care and operations and the ability to offer personalized use cases and solution sets. So this is where we see, really you see this kind of happening back in the OSS, BSS side of the house, where, hey, these guys need to use this for their customer care agents. Lilac mentioned that. The co-pilots, so they can actually think about next step actions to actually go and solve problems faster in the network. And then also thinking about, hey, here's a profile on my customers to offer them a better package or a better set of services. The final use case I would say that we'd bucketize overall is revenue generation.
Oh yeah.
Right, and it's so critical in the telecom space where for a while the operators have been looking for the next set of services. What should we bring out? So we're seeing things around GPU as a service as a really interesting offering. Especially we're seeing this moving in the APJ, Asia-Pac regions. We're seeing this a bit in Europe as well. That's one set of use cases where people are looking from a sovereign AI perspective for the telecom operators to offer these services to their enterprises. The other one I would say is for private network and edge AI use cases. We're starting to see this, probably what I think is the beginning of the hockey stick, of more and more edge type of private network use cases utilizing AI in the local places at the edge to do things like visual processing, security, footfall analysis, you name it. So we're starting to see the revenue generating type of applications around AI really start to boost up as well. So our solution set combines the best of Dell servers with some of the best GPUs in the market.
And the software stack.
A wonderful software stack that actually enables people to create these use cases, right?
Agree. And I'll say, to add to Andrew's point, it's AI now gave Telco an opportunity to claim back up revenue opportunity that they didn't have before, right? Or they lost throughout the year. So think about offering GPU as a service, AI as a service. A lot of telcos were in the cloud business. They're now back into that. And I think with macroeconomics conditions and funding of AI, sovereign AI, this is a really fruitful, you know, I'll say an economy for the telco to participate, and that's a totally new opportunity for them.
All right, so create new efficiencies, drive growth, and just better serve your customers. Andrew, there's a lot to see on the stand here. Any specific examples you'd like to call out?
Yeah, let me give you three examples like we've seen with customers, right? So, first one off, I'll take a real basic one. We have Connecticut here. We have a wonderful solution with NVIDIA, Connecticut. It's in a major tier one operator in the US. The feedback I have is they've been using it for troubleshooting. They're able to troubleshoot 4x faster than normal to figure out issues in the network. So think about that as a use case where they're able to take data from across the network, troubleshoot the issues, get a faster response back when they have a customer issue or a network issue. So real, in some ways basic, but like tangible results, like they're real results, which is so gratifying in the solution space. Another great one from a revenue generation perspective, take Lintasarta in Indonesia with the Merdeka GPU as a service capabilities. This is like a real example of a sovereign AI GPU as a service where the telecom operator is actually offering this for the country's enterprises, right? So wonderful use case there. We have another one where I'll take the one we talked about with customer care, OSS, BSS. SKT is a great example of this. They've built out an AI MNO platform. They've built out an LLM with other operators to offer a chatbot for faster, you know, service to customers calling in. These are all like tangible examples where you see massive improvements in the network, new use cases, as well as better customer care overall.
And there's an added value to it, and I will add, is that the simplicity of consuming it, if I may add. Right, so if you think about it, we just saw NVIDIA publish the State of AI report, and telcos are still saying, look, our bottlenecks is skills. But when Dell is coming over and said, look, I've got a solution for you, right? It's a, you know, ready solution with the hardware and the software, but guess what? It's also with the application, right? This is where you have Connecticut preloaded, you have Amdocs preloaded, you have a set of partners that kind of give you from day one the ability to either monetize or get the value faster to market.
Yeah, that's what I kind of wanted to hear from you, Lilac, is as I walked around the Fira today, everybody's got an AI play. That is the predominant theme here, period, full stop. So that differentiation, you know, you are obviously working with Dell on this solution, but you mentioned a larger ecosystem of partners, and you also highlighted this ease of consumption.
Yeah.
But maybe just really highlight for us, what is that differentiation that Dell and NVIDIA provide with this joint solution?
We can go for hours, but I'll try to find the three main things. The first one is that end-to-end solution, that it's make it easier to consume, really taking out the major obstacle, which is, hey, I don't have the skills to do it, how would I do that, right? So you now have a platform, with the software, with agentic AI platform. NVIDIA brings the agentic AI platform kind of ready to consume by the telco. Those agentic AI platform, first and foremost, kind of help the telco generate agent faster. We help them generate smarter agents, and we bring blueprints, recipes of how to create, you know, follow this recipe and create an agent. So we're bringing that ready, or applications ready. Go take it, right? That's a beautiful one. The second thing I'll say, and we should never forget the other side of the coin, the monetization. The ability to take a platform and not be just the first tenant. It's a secure full stack for a telco as a first tenant, but I can now take it and monetize it to the enterprise. You heard a couple of examples where telcos actually took it and create services outside to education, to healthcare, to government. So that end-to-end solution, secure, ready to use, powered by the NVIDIA technology that makes it easier, faster to get the value to market, is the key in my mind. I hope I didn't forget anything. But
no, that was great. It was very comprehensive. Like if I had summarized it, I mean, best-in-class technology across both companies is clear. The second piece is we have the supporting services offerings between the two companies to make it real. Everything from use case analysis to data analysis to how you would actually build out the infrastructure to the software, et cetera, to build these applications, it's covered. And then the final piece, just to reiterate what Lilac said, we're bringing an ecosystem with us that's vetted and tested, and we know it's real. So we run that internally, and that's actually one of the biggest benefit I've been hearing directly from telecom operators is, hey, I need somebody else to tell me there's so many, you know, people in the ecosystem that say they do it, what's real, what's not, and we have a set of ecosystem partners that have tangible results that we've vetted.
And I should also add one point, our technology partnership, we work so closely together, right? So NVIDIA developed with Dell a reference architecture, benefiting the hardware from the networking, the full stack, co-develop, co-design, to make it the most optimized for any enterprise, and especially for telco.
Well, it's a really compelling offering. It's a great partnership, and I appreciate you taking the time to share your thoughts about it with our audience.
Great. Thanks, Ron.
Thank you.